Treyarch, I see what you're trying to do, bro, but no. What's up, y'all, and welcome back to my channel. I am Theyani, the mother-loving Kai King, and you're tuning in to Theyani Cinema. Today's video, we got some Call of Duty 2020 news, y'all. Woo! The news been coming out, y'all. The news has been coming out, and as y'all can see, I have been covering it, man. I'm not gonna stop on the Call of Duty content, even though I'm not feeling it. But we got some good news, y'all. We got some good news. Oh my God, we got some really good news, bro. I'm telling y'all, we got some real good news. I'm gonna put up on the screen so I can check it out too, man. But before we get into it, man, listen. Yo, my content is already fire. But listen, if you got you one of these, man, you know, you chiefing right now while you watching this, bro, you'll have a way much better experience. But like your ghetto black YouTuber always say, pugs, not drugs. Pugs, not drugs. Let's go ahead and get to this video. Now, Treyarch has been talking to the pro players, you know, flying them out, having them come out, you know, say, hey, what's your info on the game and stuff like that, getting their input on the game. All right? That's good news. Now, I ain't went into it yet. I just heard about it, but we're going to go into it later. I just want to get my take on it before we get into it. But pretty much, Treyarch is flying out the pros to help them out, you know, out on the game. Now, last time we heard this was the first time we heard this. And that was a Black Ops 2, man. Woo. Black Ops 2 was good. Don't matter how great Black Ops 2 was, it did have its flaws. It did. And the main thing that was wrong with Black Ops 2 was it was pushing that competitive scene too hard, bro. They was pushing it too hard. Black Ops 2 is the reason why everybody's sweating nowadays, bro. Black Ops 2 is the reason why. Yo, Black Ops 2 is the reason why I'm a sweat, bro. Well, I'm an ex. I never been a sweat. I always been an anti, bro. I always been an anti, man. Because back then, you can carry a whole team, bro. You can literally carry a whole team. So I was a lone wolf. I get up in that thing, be a full team of try hard sweats, bro. And if you was a good player, you could dominate a full team, bro, by yourself. Because they had, like, swarms in their dogs, bro. One player in kill streaks overlap, so you get in there, you start going off. Bro, you'll make the whole, it don't matter if they're a full lobby, what, you'll make them leave, bro. Once they get the swarm, yo, it's old game over, bro. That's the nuke. The swarm was the nuke equivalent, all right? Treyarch know better, bro. This is Treyarch. I'm gonna tell y'all about Treyarch. It's genius. Why they have the best studio? Why they need a pass in the upcoming game? If even though all this good news is coming out, even though this news that's coming out ain't that great, it's good, but it's not that good. I'm gonna tell y'all why. I need to stop wasting time going getting to it. But the news is good because the pro players 10. To be some of the best players in the world. That's what I say. How many teams? I just say it's 50 teams out there. Each team have 12 members, man. Y'all do the math. You know, that's not a lot compared to everybody who play Call of Duty. See what I mean? I said this on my previous videos, but I have seen the Super Bowls of Call of Duty esports. Like, this is like, it don't get no higher than this. This is the biggest game. This is a championship game. Korean Savage was doing a live stream. He was live streaming the lot. Like, he was buying all the tiers and opening up a bunch of stuff. He was live streaming that and doubling the views of the Call of Duty championship, bro. And I was watching that. I was like, bro, what the hell? Yo, they should tell him. They should look at that and be like, maybe we should focus more on the regular players, because yo, there are players that are bringing in more views than our Super Bowl. Like, this is what all these players have worked for. This is what they came to achieve, and everybody else on this dude channel, they ain't paying attention to these dudes, man. It's a lot of great players out there, man. I don't want to disrespect the Karma, man. Karma is dude got 3 rings, bro. I don't care if you got 3 rings in anything, bro. You have earned my respect. Mad shout out to Karma out there, bro. Heck yeah, you got 3 rings and anything. Bro, I wonder how many rings Skump got, bro. He got at least have two because Carmen and Scumby should play together. He got at least have two or one. But you got three. I mean, you can have three rings and and a frog throwing contest, bro. I don't know. Shout out, man. I don't know, Peter. Well, don't come get me, please. Don't come get me, please. But if you have three rings and throwing frogs, bro, you earn my respect, bro. You're a three-time champ and throwing frogs? Dap me up, bro. Let's go, bro. So, this man is obviously great. Obviously great. And other players like him is obviously great. But you're going to get all the great stuff, but it's going to be different. Somebody like me or like you, if we're going to design a game, what are we going to design, right? Fun, right? That's going to be the first thing to go into mind. This will be fun. What's going in the pro mind is strategic. You know, hey, how can I get the advantage? What's some good control spots? You know, like, this would be good. Now, you should put a head glitch here. You should make this weapon do. That's what we're going to get. Instead of getting fun and excitement, that's what we're going to get. It's all going to be nice, but guess what? It's going to be nice for them. So when they go play, you know what's going to happen? They're going to be having a good time. I won't tell you why they're going to have a good time and why we not. They play from a whole different set of rules than we do, bro. It's not the same game. It is literally, it's a game within the game that they play. I'm telling you, it's not the same. That's why I don't see how people who's not into the pro scene, who don't do game battles, I don't see how they into it, because it's a whole nother game. Unless you just trying to watch them to get better, which you should be watching me to get better, because no, they don't use all the same attachments, all the same class. It might be a gun or a class that's so badass that you will never know, because you're always using their classes, because they can't use certain attachments or certain weapons or certain perks and stuff. See what I mean? That's the difference. And they, and like all the cheese, they don't have to deal with no cheese, bro. No cheese. If they don't want a dog biting them in their butt, if they don't want, some crossbows or something, or something cheesy in the game, yo, they take it right out. They take it right out. They ain't got to deal with what we got to deal with. Let's go on and get into this update, man. I'm going to put it up here for y'all can check it out. But pro Call of Duty players meeting with Treyarch to discuss esport futures. All right. Hold on. See, that's why I probably need to read it first. All right. Pros, professional Call of Duty League player Chance. See, y'all don't know who Chance is, man. No disrespect to Chance. I'm going to look you up, pimp, and see what you got, man. You better at least have... had you at least one ring like my boy Karma, bro. Dude got three, bro. And he talking about he see the future of Call of Duty. He don't want no part of it. Who is part of the Florida Mariners roster has said on Reddit that fans should be hopeful. Hey, I'm already hopeful, man. I'm already hopeful. Yeah, let's go. Let's go. The Treyarch's new 2020 Call of Duty game releasing later this year. I'm already hopeful. Heck yeah. Told y'all it was good news, man. Told y'all it was good news. In a post on Reddit, he notes that Treyarch has already reached out to esports players to get their feedback on how and have an open discussion about future set for Call of Duty 2020 title. Oh, and see, they're talking about more than just esports too. See? It's good, though. It's good. But bad at the same time. Which is rumored to be Black Ops Cold War. Black Ops 5, y'all. Chess says on Reddit that they have had meetings to discuss competitive philosophy for the 2020 title. Uh-oh, here it is, y'all. You sound like Chance something. W, Modern Warfare, I guess. I don't know, WM, that's back, I don't know, 18 hours ago. Stay hopeful, guys. The devs over at Treyarch are really interested in making next year a great year for competitive. Oh my God, no. I am being 100% serious, no. I said freak. Please tell me this isn't the usual yearly comments, because I've been hearing this from pros for a few years now. Bro, they cold with it. Bro, they is cold with it. Dang, that's what's up. That is true, man. Thank you for people catching on. Listen, if you feel that way, you need to subscribe to more people like me and people out here speaking the truth. Stop subscribing to these people who just feeding y'all bull, because guess what? They not gonna make the game better. Yo, if everybody actually spoke how they feel about this game instead of Optic and Karma waiting. Yo, I've been telling how I feel about this game for longer. But people like Optic and Karma want to wait until the next game almost coming out. So you realize they want to quit and say all this when the next game about to come out. See this? I think they slick, bro. If everybody come out and just say how we feel, they will have no choice but to fix this. It's low-key like what's going on with the protests, you know, with the movement. Like, real talk, like, if we all come together, we can fix Call of Duty, bro. Listen, I ain't one of them black people that protest all the time, but listen, y'all. I'm not saying let's go protest, but listen, if we all just say, listen, Activision, listen, we are sick of this, and we want you to fix your game, and we just stop playing it. Oh, they would fix their game so fast, bro. Activision would calm down like, okay, what's going on? What's the numbers? Zero. He would fire Joe Cuckold and all them other boys. Ooh, they would be gone so quick. Infinity Ward would no longer exist. Bro, you see how they got, who they got out of there? Sledgehammer? See how they got Sledgehammer out of there quick? Bro, they'll get Infinity Ward out of there so goddamn quick, bro. Bro, they'll be dissolved in the Treyarch soap, bro. I'm telling y'all, the power. Let's get some more in. Oh, boy, I'm telling y'all, man. Many esports fans, it's all about esports, has been upset over Modern Warfare. Yes. But stop talking about competitive. Bro, it's all about competitive, bro. Listen. It's all about competitive, dog. It's good news and bad news at the same time. Because Black Ops 2 had a heavy, heavy competitive feel to it. That's why I didn't hold your hands. And I talked about some of my previous videos. I didn't go check them out. Black Ops 2 didn't hold your hands. All right? It was really competitive. That's why if one player went off, he can carry the whole freaking team, bro. But the design of it was like, come on, man. It's you're making it too competitive. And that launched this whole wave of just extra, like, they looked at, I told y'all, this is what they do. They see what works, and they follow that trend. They ride it out. Then they find what's next. They find the next thing that works, and they just ride it out. That's exactly what's going to happen. It's good news and bad news, because we're going to get a game more competitive to the pros. But we not with the game we want, because the pros don't have to play with the rules that we have to play with. We play from a whole different rules. It's a whole different game for us. All right? This is your boy Theonic, man. The God King. And I'm signing out. Peace.